Aussies becoming a bunch of softies. TBL trainer Shannan Ponton believes there is an obesity problem because people just can't say no, even though some experts blame food groups like sugar and say people are too time poor to be healthy. It is today's Daily Dilemma. Please welcome from news.com.au, Alison Stevenson. Hi. Are we just soft, Ali? Is that the problem?
Well, I think we're getting a little bit soft around the middle as much as we're getting soft with our behaviour. But look, I think Shannan raises a really good point. We, you know, look for excuses. We blame genetics, we blame the fact that we're time poor. But he said it really is so simple. You know, it comes down to just saying no to those foods that we know aren't good for us. According to the Heart Foundation, 3.9 million Australians are obese and a further 5.1 are overweight. Now, that's 63% of our population. And if that's not a wake-up call, I don't know what is.
Wow. And that's adults, obviously.
Yeah.
Is it people not saying no to themselves or people not saying no to their kids? Because I know with my beloved Henry, I'm not allowed to give him little chippies anymore because the doctor said I was an abusive parent. But apparently if you I don't know if this is true or not, but you're actually programming a kid to process food in a different way if you're giving them fried or processed foods or sugary foods when they're young.
Exactly. And when you're giving it to them sort of as a reward and as a treat, they associate that with being something good. And so they sort of crave it all the time. So you have to find the right balance between, you know, making sure that your child is eating a healthy diet, but eating things in moderation.
But I think Shannan's really talking about adults who eat too much. You know, the portions are too big and you're full, but somebody comes out with a biscuit or a pavlova or an ice cream and so you say, oh, yeah, I'll have that too, and so you shovel it in. Mm. And every time you do that, your gut gets bigger. Mm. And so you're actually feeding this monster inside of you which wants more and more fuel. Mm. So you have to... It's a discipline and it's not always easy because, you know, you can look at a biscuit and think, I wouldn't mind that at all. And you think, but I, you know... If I have that today, I can't have the cake on the weekend. So you have to exercise restraint.
Habits are really hard to break, though. And once it's completely ingrained, and that's the way you socialise, it's the way, you know, it's really hard to stop.
Yeah, but it's better to stop than kill yourself with a chronic disease because you're obese.
So exactly, the identifier, what's going to make you stop?
I think the dirty little secret is much more prevalent in poorer areas of higher socioeconomic disadvantage. So maybe it's an education thing, maybe it's a food and access anyway, but...
There you go. You can read all about it at news.com.au. Ali Stevenson, thank you very much for joining us.